From German machines to Russian monsters to American implements of destruction, these are the 10 biggest tanks to ever leave the assembly lines. Number 10, the American Sherman Tank. Now folks, just in case if you have ever thought that size doesn't matter, well, at least when it comes to tanks, it matters. The Sherman Tank is probably the American star of the Second World War. In fact, it was the most used American tank of all time. From the time of the US entry into the Second World War, that is, from 1941 to 1945, a staggering 53,000 plus tanks left the American war factories. And guess what? The president wanted even more tanks produced. That is clearly enough proof to say how tough and effective this tank was on the battlefield. This mega tank weighed well above 39 tons and had a fair enough speed for something that weighed that much, 17 miles per hour. And once its gasoline tank of 175 gallons was fully loaded, it had a far-reaching operational range of 150 miles. Unbelievable, isn't it? In fact, it was one of the most efficient tanks for its size and firepower. Besides, its 75mm main gun and mounted machine gun could decimate the enemies in no time. No wonder Americans loved it. And here is something interesting. Apart from the Second World War, the Sherman tank served in many other wars too. These include the Korean War, Indo-Pakistan Wars, and even Arab-Israeli Wars. Number 9, German Tiger Tank. Here is another fatal and destructive tank that devastated its enemies during the Second World War, the Tiger Tank. It was originally designed by the German industrial engineer Ferdinand Porsche, who also founded the Porsche Car Company. It was named Tiger due to its complex design and driving system. The Tiger Tank weighed a massive 60 tons or 120,000 pounds and had an engine that consumed over 150 gallons of fuel. It was 21 feet long, 12 feet wide, and 10 feet tall. With its size, it could house a crew of 5 people. It was more like a small moving house that could lay destruction to anything in its path. It is widely regarded as the most brilliantly designed German tank, but some say it was over-engineered, especially since it was a difficult task to produce this item. Only 1,347 Tigers were built during the war. The Tiger had a notorious firepower relative to other tanks at the time. Its main gun was a huge 8.8 centimeter gun, the biggest gun mounted on a tank at the time. However, the size and weight of Tiger gave it 2 main weaknesses, maneuverability and speed. But the fact remains the same, it was one of the biggest and meanest tanks ever produced. Number 8, German Jagdtiger. This one has a fitting name that goes well with its design. Jagdtiger means hunting tiger in German, and this one was made as a tank destroyer. Jagdtiger was Germany's answer to the growing number of new tank types of British, American, and Soviet forces. And it was a tremendous success. Although Germany was losing the Second World War at the time, hearing the mere name Jagdtiger sent chills down the spines of tank operators on the battlefield. Being designed as a tank destroyer, naturally it had more firepower than an average tank. And it was bigger and heavier too. It weighed almost 145,000 pounds or 72 tons. It was 35 feet long, 12 feet wide, 9 feet tall, and could house a crew of 6 soldiers. Although bigger and heavier, it was relatively faster and more agile than most of the tanks at the time. Can you believe that this 145,000 pound giant could move as fast as 35 miles per hour? It seems slow, but with its size, it is quite surprising, isn't it? Another interesting fact about Jagdtiger was its armor. It was much thicker and stronger than that of a tank. Although this 9.8 inch armor was not impenetrable, it took a hell of a firepower to breach it. However, since it was designed in 1944, the German army couldn't benefit fully from its potential. Only about 88 were produced, but had the Germans had it way before, things could have been much more painful for the Allies. Are you a war history buff? What is your favorite piece of war history? Is it a particular tank, or an airplane, or perhaps a naval ship? Let me know what you liked learning about the most, and maybe it will come up in a future video on the biggest. Just put it in a comment down below. Then be sure to subscribe if you haven't already, so you can see your idea in a video very, very soon. Number 7. American M6 Heavy Tank. Here is another American dream that didn't quite come true. It's the M6 Super Tank. Developed to match the superior firepower of German tanks, you can bet that this truly was a super tank. The M6 Super Tank weighed as much as 126,500 pounds, or almost 60 tons. It was 28 feet long, 10 feet wide, and 10 feet tall. It was designed to carry a crew of 6. But the main thing the American engineers were focusing on was its firepower, since the German tanks were humiliating allies with their Tiger and Panther tanks. So they mounted 2 very big guns on the M6. One was a 76mm main gun, and the other was an equally powerful 37mm secondary weapon. Having 2 big guns was a new feature for tanks, but the guns and their ammunition added to their weight and speed, and maneuvering issues popped up as a result. After only producing 40 trial units, the Americans abandoned the project and moved on with developing their already successful Sherman tank series. Number 6. The British Tortoise. The British wanted a heavily armored tank that could withstand any heavy bombardment on the battlefield, especially when they were up against heavy German fortifications on the battlefield. And this is what they came up with, the Heavy Assault Tortoise. It gets its name from the ultra-strong armor it had, which was almost 10 inches of thick steel. It was 33 feet long, 13 feet wide, and almost 10 feet tall. No wonder it was 156,000 pounds, or 78 tons. And guess what? It could only move at a speed of 4 miles per hour. No wonder it was named Tortoise. It could have been one of the slowest tanks if it was ever deployed onto the battlefield. However, because of mobility and speed issues, only 6 prototypes were produced, and they abandoned the project. Number 5. British TOG 2. It seems like Germans were ruling the technical race to the heaviest and biggest tanks. Well, here is the British answer to that. Meet TOG 2, the heaviest Brit there ever was. The British developers surely knew how to design a heavyweight when they made the prototype TOG to be 160,000 pounds. It was 33 feet long, 10 feet wide, and 10 feet tall. With its size, it could support a crew of 6 easily. Since it was a designed prototype and never had any actual production, various guns and attachments were mounted on it during trials. But the most destructive weapon it had was the 76.2mm main gun. With such a weapon at its disposal, it could have blasted any tank with just 1 shot. However, with bigger sizes comes bigger problems. Speed and maneuverability were the biggest problems for TOG 2. With that much weight, not so surprising, isn't it? It only achieved a maximum speed of 8.5 miles per hour, and these issues convinced the British not to move on with the project any longer. Number 4. American T-28. Meet the T-28, the American Leviathan that never really made it to the battlefield. I'd be very accurate if I said the T-28 tank was the biggest and heaviest American dream to not come true. In fact, the T-28 tank was initially designed with many big dreams. This behemoth was designed as a 200,000-pound monster tank killer with an enormous firepower that many of the contemporary tanks didn't possess. It held a mounted 105mm gun, one that outshone all the guns other tanks had. It was a massive 36 feet long, 15 feet wide, and almost 10 feet tall. However, because it required a lot of space for the ammunition for its big gun, it could only fit in a crew of 4 members. Know something cool about the T-28? Its armor was almost 12 inches thick, so being inside one of these must have been like living inside a medieval castle. Impressive, right? However, it seems like the T-28 tank was too big and too slow to be fully combat operational. And since the World War was already over by the time of its development, this mighty tank found itself on the way to an abandoned tank yard. By the way, haven't you subscribed to The Biggest yet? If not, do go ahead and click that subscribe button. The content here will keep you well informed with the most interesting stuff you need to know. And hey, don't forget to share this video with your friends. Number 3, the French FCM F1. France, the land of Napoleon, is not well known for its tanks. But know what? They did try to build one of the largest tanks ever imagined. Although that became a forgotten dream, it's worth knowing how big they wanted it to be. The French super heavy tank FCM F1 was in its designing phase when France surrendered to Germany after being defeated by them on the battlefield early in World War II. Only a wooden mock-up could be built, and a real tank never really left the production lines. It was designed to be heavily armored with over 5 inches of thick steel plate. Its elongated chassis design had 2 shooting turrets. The main armament mounted was a 90mm heavy gun, and the secondary weapon was to be a heavy machine gun and several anti-aircraft guns. Imagine all those guns and armor. It was no surprise the tank was well over 200,000 pounds. It was designed to break through enemy fortifications and not to fight tanks. Maybe that's why they made it so humongous. But French engineers didn't have enough time to prepare it for production, since producing such a gigantic tank was a super complex process and had many secondary processes attached to it. And that was the end of that. Number 2, the German Panzerkampfwagen 8 Maus. Now let's get to see some wild dreams and the wild naming conventions of the German engineers. This supermassive tank was almost 380,000 pounds, or 187 tons. It was 33 feet long, 12 feet wide, and 12 feet tall. It required 6 people to run it. And that's not all about it. Its armor was a 9-inch thick steel plate that was almost impenetrable, and its 128mm main cannon and 75mm heavy machine gun gave it an immense firepower that easily outmatched any of its peers. And that's not all about it. Do you know that this heavyweight was able to submerge itself safely and travel underwater too? Yes, obviously it was too heavy to cross any bridge, so the only alternative was this. Incredible, isn't it? However, the Maus never really made it out to the battlefield, since it was produced in late 1944, and Germany surrendered several months later. Well, at least it is a fascinating museum piece. Number 1. Landcruiser P-1500 Monster. And now to see the biggest of them all. Believe me when I say this, this tank is almost mythical and legendary in the world of tank warfare. This is the monster itself. A 3.5 million pound, that is 1,794 ton, mega monster that was prophesied by the German army to rule the battlefield. It was supposed to be nearly 100 feet long, 40 feet wide, and almost 4 stories tall, that is 27 feet, and it would have needed a crew of over 100 to operate it. Its main weapon was designed to be a monster 40-inch cannon, and its armor was as thick as 10 inches of pure strong steel. However, the estimated maximum speed for this monster was only 4 miles per hour. But that didn't make it any less dangerous, given the destructive and menacing firepower it possessed. Luckily for the Allies, this German mega monster never became a reality, and was only limited to the blueprints of a wild-eyed engineer. But this is clear. Germans surely knew how to name their tanks with bizarre, fanciful names. And that is all for today, folks. I'll see you again soon with another incredible video just like this one. Don't forget to subscribe to The Biggest and tell your friends about this impressive video. Until next time, see you later.